Hello, and welcome back to Destiny, the Taken King.
Ooh, fancy.
Yeah, you might be confused, that's quite alright. So, the Taken King, when it came out, it's changed all the menuing and everything, so we're not actually in the Taken King content, but we are still in the expansion, if that makes sense.
Right, that makes sense.
Yeah, kind of like if you were playing World of Warcraft and you loaded up, say, you were still in, like, the classic areas and you were in the Burning Crusade, that sort of thing.
Yeah. So, all right, we don't need to go into any more detail, I'm sure people understand.
You gotta explain things sometimes, I'm sorry. So, we're taking a quick stop in the tower, because, with the Taken King, they've added, whereas before it was kind of a freeform thing, you could go pretty much any mission you were available to do. Now they've kind of reined that back and set you on a single path, trying to, I guess, create a little cohesiveness in the story.
So, this is a long loading screen.
It is. The tower always loads pretty slowly, for whatever reason.
Probably. Oh, so I just... Sorry, I just thought of something. Does this mean something has changed... Spectre related?
I'm sorry. Oh, yes, yes indeed. We'll be hearing that not too long from now. So the Taken King added a couple of things. The tower has changed around, not too much, but a little bit. There is a new vendor. She sells things for a currency that you buy with real money. So microtransactions have become a part of the game.
There he is. There's a big boy.
Yeah. But, other than that, there's not too much different. There's a couple new NPCs down by the Vanguard, that we'll be dealing with way, way later in the LP. But yeah.
Why are those remains controversial?
Who knows? Warlocks are weird.
It's like made of femur. Human femur. That's pretty controversial.
So, after we check our mail, we're actually going to check out the new vendor. Something I have not actually explained in any of these videos is that there are emotes that you can do by pressing D-pad buttons. And this vendor sells exclusively emotes. And, well, other goodies, but mostly just emotes.
Okay.
We found our emote.
Oh God.
So, the game doesn't
shake my damn head.
The game starts you out with 200 of the silver, which is the currency you buy with real money. And yeah.
Memes.
So I don't know why she still has a quest marker over her head. I honestly just don't know. But that's why
I hate the internet.
So yeah, we're equipped with one out by default, but praise the sun. Anyway, moving on. The real reason we stopped by is because we need to talk to the Vanguard.
Sorry, I'm in silent disgust right now.
You see there's a quest over Shax's head there. He's actually the Crucible Quartermaster, and he deals exclusively with the PvP stuff. We're not going to deal with that right now, so we're going to ignore that.
Jeez. Where are your manners? Just walking on a table?
It's a thing that I just do. The Vanguard understands. The life of a Guardian is very extravagant. Well done.
The table I have at home is 10 times more expensive than this. I wipe my feet on your table.
Do you really think Ugg sounds like that? Come on.
I mean, maybe it's
Ugg,
like...
Ugg,
you know,
stand on table. Ugg, more imposing.
I was thinking more maybe it's like, you know, they call tall people tiny. Maybe it's like, like they call him Ugg, but he's actually really intelligent. And sophisticated. No, it's Ugg. He has, like, two brain cells clinking together.
heed the challenge.
So, yeah, we got a piece of armor that we can't equip. Whoop, woo, yay. So, that's all we
have. Exciting times.
That's all we have in the tower. Also, before I forget, look, I can't even choose hard mode anymore. It requires light level 240, and as I'm about to show you, we are nowhere near that right now. So.
Oh, okay. Well, no more bullet sponges, Thread. We did it.
Actually, I kind of wish I could have done this mission on hard mode because, you'll see.
We gave up the moon to keep the Hive away from Earth. We hoped that would be enough for them. I used to look up here at night and wonder what the Hive were doing, but the only activity I could ever pick up was hazy, like it was blocked or buried.
Now we've got we've got Nola North doing the voiceovers.
Welcome to the moon.
I mean,
a guardian came here.
So I have half a feeling it would have been cool if he would have just done Nathan Drake as a ghost.
Oh my god! Coordinates are up ahead. That would be hilarious. So yeah, we're on the moon. New locale, new act, new sights to see, and lots of Hive to kill. Hey, look, there's Earth.
Killed like 10 people.
It was probably a Fallen who very much deserved it.
Well, that's true. There's not many people on Earth, is there?
No. So, you may notice we don't have access to our Sparrow yet, but we'll be fixing that here in a moment. So, one thing about Destiny is that all of the planets you visit
the Guardian's last report
are
said he
segmented into different enemy types. Like on Earth, it was Fallen and Hive. Well, the Moon is the same. It's Fallen and Hive, though more in the Hive's favor. So we'll be fighting more Hive than Fallen in here.
Okay. More bugs.
More dead things that worship other dead things, yes.
Yeah. I still see that similarity between, whatever the name is in Mass Effect.
Oh, jeez. Now you got me thinking about it.
It begins with R.
R. Rachni?
No, not the Rachni. Those are the bug people. It's, the big baddies that are trying to destroy humanity. Reapers, that's the one. Reminds me a lot of the Reaper plot lines.
A little bit, I guess. So, hey, we just turned the lights on and they're back off again. What gives?
Damn Hive chewing through the power cords.
Actually, in this case, it's Fallen, but it works.
Oh.
I can see that happening. Just some stupid drag. Oh, this looks tasty.
Or it was Ugg. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised.
So we're using a new weapon type. Well, we've seen it before, but it's definitely way updated. We're using an auto rifle, so it's your basic assault rifle equivalent, nothing new. One thing I found with this particular assault rifle, or auto rifle, whatever you want to call it, it does piss poor body damage, but if you hit him in the head, it's great. And another new weapon type, the machine gun.
And then this gun just kills them in two hits.
Pretty much. It's a heavy weapon, so it's kind of to be expected.
High inaccuracy, high fire rate, high damage.
Actually, I don't want to call them sub-classes of the weapons, but it's kind of what they are. Like, auto rifles have two variants, and machine guns have two variants. One fires really fast and does less damage, and one fires really slow but has awesome damage.
Yeah, it makes it. That's pretty standard MMO FPS fare.
Yeah.
The slower the weapon fires, the more damage it does.
Yeah, pretty much. There was an enemy that actually fell down that ravine. I don't know how.
He's a base jumper. He's a thrill seeker.
I don't know how. I've never seen it happen before.
He was just really, really into the thought of killing you to the point where he just lost all control and had to jump off a cliff. Oh no, it's one of these things.
Yeah, it's a servitor. I like how that captain dodged right out of the way so I could hit his friend. Teamwork.
You can grab your spell now. We're linked.
I don't know if you've noticed, but as we were walking up, this thing was dark as anything, and now it's all bright and flashing. We did something.
We saved the moon.
Well, we started the process. So, another new mechanic. Enemies also have vehicles. In fact, I think it's just this one, but yeah. The Fallen occasionally have pikes around. They're basically like your Sparrow, but they have weapons attached.
Seems more like a... Is it a ghost?
Actually, yeah. It operates much the same way as a ghost would in Halo. The longer you hold the fire button, the slower it fires, and you have to let it recharge to get it back to full fire rate again. So yeah, you could say it's a ghost.
I mean, it is Bungie, so it makes sense.
Yeah, yeah. I don't like these things too much. I'd rather just avoid the confrontation altogether on my Sparrow. But I wanted to show this off, because I'm probably not going to do it later.
So you should show it off.
Meh.
This is a completionist OP, after all.
As much as I can, yeah. There's a lot of things I won't be able to show off, unfortunately, but that's all RNG and a lot of hard work.
Standard MMO grinding.
Mm-hmm.
Where did you get your license from? Jeez.
You know, Ugg, I don't think Ugg ever got his license.
No, that wouldn't surprise me. He'd fail the line to the DMV. Hey, I got all the zingers today. Poor Ugg never stood a chance.
That's okay. As long as he has his killer instinct, he'll be fine.
Yeah, pretty much. He may not be smart, but he can kill the hell out of a lot of dudes.
That's true. Looks and like he has space magic here to do it with now. Let's see what he terrifying.
Who gave a caveman space magic?
You know? Maybe our ghost was just on some space drug or something. He's like, this guy looks good.
He was hopped up on some red electricity?
Something. It's not far from here. Sounds like a death trap. So hey, look down there. There's a level 40 fighting some things.
Hey look, he's sending you into a death trap. He must have sobered up and realized his mistake. So wait, what's the level 40 doing in such a lobby area?
He's probably do
the enemies scale up or something?
No. He's probably farming for materials, if I had to guess. Because all your armor upgrades later on. Hello, Cliff. all your armor upgrades are tied to the materials you find on the planets.
Okay.
Sorry, that scream gets me every time.
The ground here is hollowed out for miles.
Sorry, we can blame it on Ugg.
Who knows what's happening under your feet?
So Ugg, this is... you're drunk on blood.
This fight up here is the reason why I wish this was on hard mode. This fight coming up, this ambush, is actually notoriously hard, or used to be.
Guardian down.
And you're gonna see what's gonna happen here. But first, let's get a cutscene out of the way. The first since we started Earth, actually.
Ooh. cutscenes.
Yeah.
Hey. Hey, you guys watching the uncut video? What's up? You get the bonus features.
There's nothing left.
All the special effects happen here.
Not even the light. Where's his ghost?
I mean, there's not nothing left. His corpse is there, right? That's something.
True. Also, our ghost is a special color. It's because the Taken King added ghost shells. Ha! Special information for only the uncut viewers. Not like it matters much. I'll explain it again at some point.
Oh no, the lady's gone.
We may want to move back.
Yeah. It's almost like we've seen her before.
I don't remember.
So here we go. This is the hard fight. Also one of Peter Dinklage's most remembered,
we've woken the hive,
most loved lines in the entire game.
And unfortunately, we won't get to see it.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Obama. Space Obama.
So yeah, this fight was very hard back when it began. Back when the game began. Not so much anymore.
I mean, I can kind of see why. If they're assaulting you with this many enemies, yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah, not so much anymore. We've woken the hive. The hive are sleeping again.
What do you mean the hive is sleeping? Because you killed them all.
Yes.
Oh. Well, not all of them, but the ones that burst out of that door.
I cleared out that entire ambush with one super, one grenade, less than a magazine of LMG ammo, and a few selective sprays of auto rifle ammo.
I'm picking up the dying light of a ghost. Inside.
This is why I wish I could have played this mission on hard.
You have to tell us when Peter Dinklage's most memorable line would have come up.
It was when we transitioned back into gameplay.
Okay.
I'll link a video in the post.
Yeah, I was going to say, link a YouTube video.
Yeah.
Nice throw.
Shut up. Watch this one. Nailed it.
Yeah. I don't know whether it makes up for that first miss, though.
I was trying to get the prompt to show up, and it was just being dumb.
The ghost is dead, but I can still read some of its memories. The Hive are raising an army here, preparing to invade Earth. We need to stop them.
And his own take on it with a bit more personality.
Well, I mean, it makes sense. The ghost always did have a bit of a dry personality. Like, intentionally dry. And then there was Wooden acting on top of that.